Hello, I'm Gordon, and I'm one of the people behind FluteFling, and I'm here in Edinburgh on a pretty dreary day and afternoon in early December. It's getting dark outside. You might hear the traffic going by. I'm sitting here in my bay window, and I've just started a project. This is the first of them, where I'm going to record some tunes. It's really, everyone needs a project over the winter, and this one, I just thought it's sitting right here. I just want to make the most of the resources I've got at the moment, and it's to record there are 10 sets of tunes that were put together for sessions in for an Aberdeen FluteFling just before the pandemic started, and it's really just some session tunes, some common session tunes, and there are 10 sets, and the aim of this project is to record all 10 sets over a period of 10 weeks ish, roughly speaking. We're going to begin right at the beginning with a couple of Shetland reels composed by Tom Anderson. The first one is very well known. It's called Hurlock's Reel. And the second one is a Darod to Houl. I think I'm pronouncing it hopefully correctly. Houl? How? I'm not sure. I'll put some supporting notes in the bottom here of the video, and I'll also blog on the FluteFling website as well, flutefling.scot. And the resources for this, this is from a PDF. It's put together by John Crawford. Should have credited him right at the very beginning. In order to help give a focus to some of the sessions, we all come from all sorts of places when we meet together for the FluteFling events and weekends. And we all bring our own repertoires, but it's good if we've got some commonality. So that was the purpose of this, and he's got a sort of an Aberdeen focus for that one, quite naturally. The PDF of this will be made freely available from the FluteFling website, and again I'll put a link to that in the notes on this. I'm going to point out a couple of things to you to begin with that may be helpful if you learn. If you're learning these tunes, or you know, just brushing them up. I haven't been playing in sessions for a while, so I had to get rid of some errors that crept in. The Hurlock's reel has got a G sharp in it. There's a few tunes in these sets that do have a G sharp. And for that, I'm playing a left-handed flute. I'm with keys on. There's my G sharp here. I do play left-handed, so hence a left-handed flute. If what I always say to people when I'm teaching is just treat it like a mirror, and you'll be fine. Just going to show you. This is the kind of like a bit I had to work on here. So just getting that pinky to move in conjunction there, just in with that third finger in the top hand. Also, something I'm trying to work on a lot is the venting, which I never used to do on my old flutes, my other flutes. And if you don't have keys, then you'll just have to work on, you know, you don't need to worry about that. And for this, you're going to half hole. Not very effective on this flute, certainly. That doesn't work too well either. But I'm venting here, and I find a very helpful. The first tune is in A, but there's not much G sharp, it's just that one passage. But I find if you're venting, which is a pretty new thing to me, if you're venting there, it makes that E sound much stronger, and the notes above it too, they just sound clearer, just sound a bit, got a bit more resonance about them. And brings it up into pitch as well. So there are a couple of things to look out for when you're looking at the first tune. When you're looking at the second one, that's much more comfortably within the flute registers. It just kind of sits very nicely. It's in G, D or G. In fact, C sharps are not played in it at all. So, I would say watch out for the breathing in that one. And what you can find is, if you're new to this, think of some of the Irish polkas, and if you and think of your breathing with it. You can do a little bit of push and pull with it, and you can really get it kind of swinging along. Okay, I would say just enjoy the tunes and enjoy working on them, and I'll see you again soon. Please leave comments, and we can make it better, and I'll sort out the lighting. If the traffic's too annoying, I'll find a better location in the flat. Okay, and thanks very much. Enjoy.